that we want, that we are unified on. We don't want police in our schools because police do not serve us. They never have.
Any police,
school police, city police. But right now, we're focusing on getting our police out of OUSD. And just to brought up a great date, the 24th. Something is happening on the 24th. Who in the audience knows what's happening? A vote for the school board if they're going to adopt the George Floyd resolution. Also, if you are listening on 88.3 and not have taken off with the caravan, please do so. The caravans have started to make their way throughout Oakland. So if you're in your car, wherever you are, and you can hear this, make some noise. Woo! Let's make some noise for Oakland High. And he's going to share with you why, as a high school principal, he believes we should defund Oakland School Police. Give a round of applause to Matthews.
Black laws?
Yeah.
Black laws?
Yeah.
Black laws?
Yeah.
I always wanted to do this. My name is Mateen Abdulkawi. I'm the proud principal of Oakland High. I've been employed by the Oakland Unified School District for over 25 years. This time is long overdue. This time is long overdue. We should have done this a long time ago. There's no need for police in our schools. There's no need for police in our schools. They don't provide a service that is of value to our young people. All educators know that it is our job to listen to student voices. We know that, we value that. And if you're not just paying lip service to it, and you really mean it, then if you've been listening to the young people, you know what they're saying. They don't like the police. They don't see them as providing any level of security in our communities. They're terrorized by the police. They're intimidated by the police. And black men are killed by the police. This should have happened years ago. Oakland Schools Police, they have a body on their record. They killed a black man at Skyline High School in 2011. Why are we just doing this now? We should have done this years ago. My sons and I have been blessed to participate in a lot of the actions that have been going on since George Floyd was assassinated. And every time we're out there, we're reminded that the students who we are here to serve, we are their servants. And they say that every valley we go to, that they want the police not only out of the schools, they want it out of our city, out of our communities, and out of all of our systems. It is not just a matter of professional development. It's not a matter of an RJ circle with police officers so they can develop a better relationship with black and brown men. Our police need to go now. So I support any effort as a long-standing employee of this district, a resident of this city, and as a black man, I support any measures that would work toward removing the police out of our communities. The millions of dollars that will be saved instead of wasting it on police officers can provide some very meaningful services to our young people. We can hire case managers, restorative justice counselors, right? We can provide services to our young people that will help them deal with the trauma they deal with in their day-to-day lives so they can come back to school and do the things that they're supposed to do. Learn, grow, develop, and have fun. And you don't need police to do that. We actually don't need police to do anything that we need as educators to do our job. So I appreciate this opportunity to say a few words. But this is not my movement. This is a movement of the youth. This is a movement of the young people. And all of us should support them in getting in the streets, participating in rallies, doing whatever it is that they need to do to make sure their voices are heard. We should be in the background supporting them. That is our job. So as Ice Cube said, fuck the police.